Today we're going to go over three Xfinity Wi-Fi hotspot tricks. Please note that all three of these tricks require no cracking, no hacking, and if you're a Xfinity subscriber like myself, it's perfectly acceptable. So trick number one is if you find yourself getting close to your 1 terabyte limit for the month, which, I mean, I honestly haven't done that in many, many months. The last time it happened to me was I had a hard drive die on me and I had to re-download all my Steam games. It was well over a terabyte. So one thing I found interesting based on a lot of forums and information that I read, if you actually connect to the Xfinity Wi-Fi hotspot that's broadcasting from your Xfinity modem, and you're just using that connection and not your primary Wi-Fi, that does not count towards your monthly data usage. So if you're in a pinch and you need a little more than a terabyte for that month, you can get connected to it and just continue downloading as needed. Now, Comcast Xfinity can correct this very easily by simply checking when you're using the data. So when you first connect to the Xfinity Wi-Fi hotspot, you do have to log in with your Xfinity account. So trick number one, if you're near your terabyte limit, get connected to the Xfinity Wi-Fi broadcast hotspot and continue downloading. On to trick number two, I pay about $100 a month for my Xfinity Comcast internet, and I only get an upload of 5 megabits per second. So when I'm in a pinch and I really need to upload a large file, I actually bond my primary connection with the Xfinity Wi-Fi hotspot that's broadcasting off my equipment. To illustrate this, I'm going to connect to the Xfinity Wi-Fi. And then I am going to use a program called Speedify that can actually bond the two connections together. Now, I will leave a link in the description below. It is free for up to 5 gigs. However, if you want to go above that, it is a monthly subscription. I was lucky enough to get a Black Friday sale, so it was pretty cheap. But if you're just using it to upload large videos to YouTube or to somewhere else and you want to utilize that extra speed, you can do so with the 5 gig free version. So I'm going to go ahead and load that up just to show you what it's like. It has detected my Xfinity Wi-Fi hotspot, and it has also detected my Ethernet cable because I only have one Wi-Fi card on this laptop. So let's go ahead and test it. Now, how this works is the software connects to a Speedify server for both connections, and then it can bond it and send it back. So right now, as you can see, the Xfinity Wi-Fi is capped, so it is a little slow, but I'm not really interested in the extra download speed. I'm more interested in the extra upload speed when it's bonded together. It's going to be interesting if I actually get above 5 on my Ethernet, but during peak hours, I generally do not. Around 5. Sweet. That's about what I normally get. Now, it's not going to give me 10 per se, but it will give it a little bit extra connection speed. Okay, it increased it quite a bit. So see, that's what I'm interested in. For me to get 10 upload, I have to pay more money. I have to go up like 3 services because whenever you're buying your services through Xfinity or Comcast, they always tell you about the download speeds. They never tell you about the upload speeds. You literally have to ask, what is the upload speed for this connection? What am I guaranteed? What do I normally get, etc. So by bonding the two connections now keep in mind, the Xfinity Wi-Fi, it's already being broadcasted. It's put aside for people to use. And since I'm a subscriber, I am allowed to use it. And as I said, I'll leave a link in the description below so you can try this out for yourself. It's got the 5 gig free version, so you can do your own testing with this. On the trick number three, Xfinity Wi-Fi hotspots actually can be used by normal everyday people. However, when you connect to them, it asks for a sign-up plan. You can get a month. I'll actually sign in and show the plans, but it also has a complimentary 30 minutes a month for one user. However, they really don't check it all that much, and I'll get into how they could rectify their own problem, but let's go ahead and get connected, and I can show you what I mean here. Okay, so I have told my system to log in as if it is a new user and not associated with my Xfinity Comcast login. So if you don't have Comcast and you connect to a Xfinity hotspot, this is what you should see. Not an Xfinity customer, no problem. So let's go ahead and hit get started. Okay, so it gives you all these different plans and everything. If you want to try it for an hour, it's $3, yada yada. So they have a complimentary hour pass, but sometimes it says half an hour depending on your location. Enjoy an hour. So let's go ahead and click on that and hit continue. No thank you. Now this is where it's the whole, I don't think it really checks it before you do it, so we're just going to go John Doe. Up. It's a just first name, so Doe, email. And I'm just putting in any old email. You can make it up. Doesn't matter. That might exist. I have no idea. And I'll just put any old zip code. So hit continue. What is your favorite movie? Doesn't matter. First thing I thought of. Continue. Activate pass. Your pass is activated. Okay, so right now you are on Xfinity Wi-Fi. I just made a random account, and in 72 hours that account will die. So let's try some stuff. Awesome. So that's a free hour every month. Now, if you're in a pinch, like you're unemployed, or you just moved and they haven't moved things over, or you're going from CenturyLink to Comcast or whatever the connection may be, let's say you use it for an hour and you're done. You now no longer have internet access. What you can do is use something called a MAC changer. What you can do is you can change your MAC address. That is literally the only thing they are using to check this, when in all reality, all they have to do is do an actual email authentication. If they get a bounce back from a fake email, they shouldn't let you on. So that's kind of their fault for not checking it. And keep in mind, this is not utilizing any cracking or any hacking whatsoever. So to simulate that, I'm going to disconnect. I'm going to forget this. I'm going to close the browser. I'm going to load up my Mac changer, and I'll leave a link to the description below for this. So it's free. What it does is the free version just changes a couple of numbers on it. It doesn't change the full. You can't put in your own. But that's enough to fake out the Xfinity Wi-Fi and allow you back on. So I've gone ahead and changed it. And right now, even though I've already been on a certificate, it should ask me for a new one. And there you go. We're right back in. Complimentary hour pass. I can literally just keep doing this and doing this and doing this over and over and over again. Now, the downside to this is every hour you have to put in a different email, make an account, and get back on. But in a pinch, if you absolutely have to get on the internet and this is your only option, I don't see an issue with it. They may. It's a pretty nifty little trick to continue using the internet. So that is three separate tricks you can use on the Xfinity Wi-Fi hotspot that's broadcasting from your home or in your area. Like I said before, there are many ways that Comcast can fix this. It may change in the future. For instance, they can start counting data on your Xfinity Wi-Fi hotspot when you're logged in under your account. They can use some type of detection for bonding, which honestly I don't think is a problem. You are a paid subscriber. You should be able to use both connections to boost your speed, especially if it's in your home. And last but not least, for the free complimentary hour, all they have to do is validate that it is a valid email. If they get a bounce back that it's an invalid email, don't let the person on. So Xfinity and Comcast, they should be able to fix these problems or flukes, glitches, hiccups, whatever you want to call them. But for the time being, you can use them to your advantage, and the software is free, and there's no hacking, cracking, programming, or anything involved, or advanced networking. And I hope you guys found this informative, and try it out yourself. Let me know how it goes. And as always, have a great one.